Good evening, everybody, and thank you so much, Cafe Mutual, for providing this opportunity to talk to so many investors today. And as Kavya was mentioning, if you have a sufficient large corpus that you built up and you need income from that corpus, then this is what you're going to save. However, I just want to start with one of the requirements with where income from the portfolio would be essential, and that's retirement phase. एक बार आप निवृत्त हो जाते हैं तो income अपने portfolio से आती है. So let's compare the two different phases of life. One is where you are working and earning, and second is you are generating income from your retirement. It's just to put in perspective, because a lot of discussions happens about pre-retirement phase. First, pre-retirement is accumulation phase, जहाँ पे आप निवेश जमा कर रहे हो. And retirement is a phase where we are withdrawing from the investment. So the cash flow reverses. That's one important difference. The difference, second, difference number two is in the accumulation phase. It is safe to assume that you've got a longer time horizon, because it is pre-retirement plus post-retirement. But in the post-retirement phase, your time horizon, and it's important to know your time horizon, especially in the retirement phase, in this times is going to be requirement of funds immediately every month for a very long inning. Longevity, 80, 85, 90 years, is becoming quite common in urban India. So if you stop working at 60, you are talking about 20, 25, 30 years of withdrawing income from your portfolio. So consider that time horizon. It is both short term as well as long term. And the third difference between the two phases is you should be happy in the accumulation phase if the investment, rather the markets, are at lower level because you are buying cheap. But in the retirement phase, when you are withdrawing, if the market falls, you could be hurt more. So be careful about these differences, and it's important to understand this. With that, let's start with the basic exercise. As management guru Simon Sinek always says, start with why. What is the objective? Why do you need this regular income? What is the purpose of that regular income? How much do you need? When do you need? So let's say starting when is what I mean. And for what period would you need that income? And are there any other conditions? Let's look at two scenarios. And for want of time, I'm not going to many other scenarios, but take, for example, a youngster or maybe a middle-aged person takes a sabbatical from work. Let's say I may want to pursue education, or I may want to pursue hobby, or I'm simply taking a break from work for a few years. In such a case, because my income from occupation stops, I may need withdrawal. So that's number one, the purpose. In that case, if you know in advance and if you planned it well, that you are going to take a sabbatical, let's say 1 year down the line or 5 years down the line, whatever the period that you define, and up to what time, this can be set up as a goal. What is the amount that you will need typically to fund your regular monthly expenses plus whatever short-term goals may come during that period? So you will need income for that purpose. What is the time period till when you'll need that income? You can decide that as well. Anything else? Well, anything else may not be that applicable in this case. Maybe a little bit of extra liquidity you may need, a little bit of tax efficiency you may need. But the second phase where you need income is the retirement phase, which we started with. The discussion was started with that. So retirement. Once again, as I said earlier, retirement income is required to fund the regular expenses and any other large lump sum expenses that you may have to incur. What period is the big uncertainty? But if that's the case, we have to start with certain assumptions and looking at your family history. So generally, if people are living longer in your family, the probability is reasonably high that you will also live longer. And if that's the case, keep that factor in mind and plan accordingly. So as I said, it could be 20, 30 years in retirement, or you may extend your work life if that's possible for many professionals, etc. What else is the critical part in retirement phase? You need liquidity. You need income that is rising year after year because your expenses are rising on account of inflation. So your income also should rise commensurately. Third, yeah, taxation. But more than that, you need a little bit of extra flexibility, access to money. The transfer or the transmission process should not be bothersome, etc., etc. So these are some of the what else that you may want to club in this equation. So set the goal. And once you set the goal, then life becomes much different. I don't want to talk too much about sabbatical. Let's go jump into retirement, because that's where biggest requirement comes in. And retirement, you need safety of capital. You need easy and convenient liquidity. Just a few years back, getting the monthly payouts from post office was very difficult. Now again, that's become a little better, but it's still not that easy or convenient. And if you need to withdraw money from some of your investments, how do you break that post office monthly income scheme? How soon do you get the money? Those questions still remain. Third, as I said, growing income is important apart from the regularity of it. And this is missed out in many cases. And finally, how do you transfer the money to the next generation? The ultimate goal in retirement for most people is to lead a life which one lived pre-retirement. But now in post-retirement phase, you want to lead that life with respect, without the title, without the chair that you are sitting on. And to that extent, you don't need to depend on somebody. That's the overall purpose. There are many traditional investment options available. I just mentioned about post office MIS. There is a senior citizen savings scheme. There are various other annuity products or bank deposits, etc., etc. But all have certain limitations. Now look at these limitations in line with the needs of the investors. All these investments have a fixed term. So post office MIS has a certain term. Senior citizen savings scheme is for a particular period. Whereas your term is often not aligned with what they have decided. Number two, these products are called fixed income products, but that fixed income is only available for that fixed period. Once the period gets over, new interest rate may be applicable. In your case, the cost of living is rising. In our case, the cost of living is rising. So to that extent, we need income that is rising year after year, whereas this remains fixed even throughout the term. And of course, we need liquidity and tax efficiency. So if these are the problems, one of the solutions that you can look at is systematic withdrawal plans from mutual fund schemes. And a lot has been talked about as far as mutual funds are concerned. This is one flexibility which is available, one convenience that is available from mutual funds. It is nothing but a kind of standing instruction that you give to the fund house. Ek bar instruction de di ki mujhe har mahine ye date ko itni amount chahiye. But that's a standing instruction that you can give. How much amount, you can decide. So let's look at this benefit or this convenience in comparison to the traditional investment. If let's say I have put money in a senior citizen savings scheme, which offers around, let's say 7.5% per year. So on a quarterly basis, you will get the annual interest rate divided by 4. So if let's say, for the sake of simplicity, let's assume it is 7.2%, 7.2 divided by 4, which will be 1.8% of your invested corpus. Which means if you invested 1 lakh rupees, यू विल गेट 1,800 रुपीज एवरी क्वार्टर वंस एवरी थ्री मंथ्स. एज अगेंस्ट दैट इफ योर एक्सपेंसेस आर आई एम जस्ट टेकिंग फॉर एग्जाम्पल 1,000 रुपीज, सो एवरी मंथ यू विल हैव टू you will be generating that 800 rupees surplus and you have to find a mechanism to reinvest that 800 somewhere. So there is an additional task involved. On the other hand, if you need 2,000 rupees as your expense, but you are getting 1,800, and I'm not taking taxation into consideration right now, but where do you get that extra 200 rupees from? So you have to plan it accordingly. In case of systematic withdrawal plan, whatever your requirement, you can give that much instruction. Now, if the mutual fund generates higher income as compared to what you are withdrawing, then the additional earning remains reinvested in the scheme and NAV moves up to that extent. That automatically, the corpus remains larger to that extent. But if the fund delivers lower return in comparison to what you are withdrawing. So let's take the same example of 1,800. For that 3 month period, you needed 2,000 rupees, but the fund generated 1,800. In that case, you withdrawn whatever was earned plus 200 rupees from the capital. I'm just putting it in terms of cash flow. Accounting happens slightly differently. So we'll not get into that right now. Or you need 1,000 rupees when the scheme has generated 1,800, you take 100 and that additional 800 anyway remains within the scheme. The second advantage is periodically, as in when your needs change, your expenses change, you can simply replace the old instruction with a new instruction. So close the old SWP, systematic withdrawal plan, and start afresh for a higher amount, because now that 1800 has gone up to 2,200, for example. You simply replaced it, instruction. So, केवल एक कागज की exchange करनी है, एक month कराना है, दूसरी शुरू करानी है. Whenever your expenses go up, and automatically your cash flow can be modified easily. So, this is another great advantage. And third big advantage is, so let's just take case of a sabbatical. I'm now just digressing a bit from retirement to sabbatical. Let's say I need certain amount of money, regular income from my investment over a 2 year period. Then what I need to do is, if I put money in a traditional investment and assume that the returns are 7%, I need to block 100 rupees for every 7 rupee of annual income. In case of mutual fund, let's say if I need 7 rupees of income, then I can simply put 15 rupees in that portfolio and keep withdrawing on a whatever frequency I want, so that 15 is exhausted in 2 years. Nothing is left in the corpus. I don't need to block the money also, large sum of money also. It's just that I'm running out of capital at the end of that period. So that's the downside that you need to look at. But it's a fine balance between convenience and whether you want to eat out of the capital or not. So these kind of flexibilities, and you can structure it whichever way you want. Now look at some of the advantages. First of all, mutual fund is a vehicle that is professionally managed. So I can buy the traditional investments myself and generate income, or I put money in a mutual fund scheme, which also invests in fixed income instruments, which generate interest income. That interest is withdrawn in form of interest or whatever is the earning. I can withdraw it in form of the systematic withdrawal. But it's a managed vehicle, which means I don't really need to worry about managing too many papers, the bond certificates or fixed deposit receipts, etc., etc. It happens at one place. The accounting of it happens at one place. NAV is calculated, as you all know, in mutual funds on a regular basis. And tax-wise also, it is slightly friendly. I'm not getting into a tax discussion, but systematic withdrawal has better tax efficiency, and it can be structured depending on your requirements. The schemes that you can pick up. आर डिफरेंट इन डिपेंडिंग ऑन योर रिक्वायरमेंट. सो लेट्स से इफ आई वर टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ पोर्टफोलियो फॉर रिटायरमेंट फंडिंग जनरेटिंग इनकम फॉर रिटायरमेंट, आई मे लुक एट different buckets where I'll put money. So let's say first 2 or 3 years worth of expenses I would put in liquid funds and withdraw from there. The other can be put into fixed income funds, or as Dhirendraji was mentioning about the balance advantage funds or hybrid funds, or if I'm a little more aggressive and longer with a longer horizon, I'm going to get equity funds also. So that could be my third or fourth bucket. I can put money in that manner, that short-term money is in liquid, medium-term money is in debt fund, and long-term money is in hybrid and equity combination. Those flexibilities are available, and there are many investment advisors or mutual fund distributors who can help structure such solutions for your unique requirement. The limitations of this plan. As I said, if the scheme generates 1800 and you want to withdraw 2000, then you are withdrawing from the capital. Or let's say normally the scheme has been generating 1800 rupees and you are also withdrawing 1600, but one bad month or one bad quarter, and for that period if the investment returns are less, then you would have withdrawn from the capital, which means it may lead to capital erosion. However, the same risk applies to any other investment. It's just that 1800 rupees withdrawal or 1600 rupees withdrawal or 2000 rupees withdrawal was your need, your expense, monthly expense. And to that extent, whether you have a fixed deposit, you have to break the fixed deposit to run the household expenses. So to that extent, it looks like a big limitation, but it applies elsewhere as well. So kehne ko yahan pe ek limitation lagta hai, but har jagah pe hai. And of course, this particular line should never be forgotten. Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Having said that, there is no investment, and I'm speaking very responsibly, main soch samajh ke bol raha hu pura, there is no investment which is without a risk. So to that extent, while mutual funds are subject to market risk, there'll be some other risk somewhere else. And one caution, if you are in the accumulation phase, which is pre-retirement phase, systematic withdrawal plan is not for you. It is only when you need income, and that's where the why comes in. Why do you need that income? Sometimes I've seen people, they simply feel good that something is coming into their bank account. Now, that good feeling is fine, feel good about it, but please understand the price that you are paying for that good feeling. You are losing the benefit of compounding in the accumulation phase. So if you are in the withdrawal phase, take money, generate income out of mutual funds. If you are in accumulation phase, this is not the product for you. And with that, let me end the presentation. Thank you so much. I hope this session was useful. There are some points that you can take home. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Amit, for a wonderful presentation. I have two questions.
Yes, please.
For you. One is asked by Bhavik Dinesh Kumar Kotari. If you have 30 lakhs in hand and if investment horizon is 5 years, what should be the investment strategy?
30 lakhs to be invested for 5 years.
Yes. So there are no other details available.
Right. So in the absence of all these details, I'm assuming that at the end of 5 years, the entire corpus has to be withdrawn.
Correct.
And in such a case, I would, not just currently, and I've got no view on the equity markets, but I would generally not be comfortable taking a larger exposure to equity markets, which means larger part of the money should be in fixed income. And depending on how aggressive or conservative you are, you may decide a percentage, but in no case, I would recommend going more than 30% in equity if the horizon is only 5 years.
Okay. Okay. And another question is, if you were to, an investor comes to you who's not in the accumulation phase. He's in the withdrawal phase of his life. Okay. And he wants regular income through a debt fund. Okay. Yeah. And he has a time. He wants regular income. He doesn't want to see short term. He doesn't want to see any fluctuation in the value in the long term. Short term, he's ready to live with some fluctuation. What would you recommend to him?
So, you said it's a retired investor, right?
Retired investor looking to generate a kind of an annuity is ready to live with some short-term fluctuation in value in the principal.
Okay.
So, but he's ready that it will even out over the 5 years, 10 years.
So, in such a case, I'm assuming that the investor is... So, I'll give two different answers. One, I'm assuming that the investor is conservative. In such a case, the first 3 years worth of expenses, that corpus would be in a liquid fund. Next 3 or 5 years would be in a debt fund. And then one can put for the balance amount can go into a balance advantage or a hybrid category of fund. Because in that case, the overall portfolio's volatility would not impact the investor's withdrawal plan.
Okay.
But if the investor is slightly more aggressive, then I'll cut that liquid fund period from 3 to 2 years and debt fund from next 5 to 3 years again. So first 5 years expenses are again taken care of from liquid and debt funds, and the balance amount can go into, I'll not go beyond hybrid, aggressive hybrid or balance advantage fund. I'll not go in that case in full equity also.
Okay. Okay. Thank you so much, Amit. That was a lovely presentation.
Pleasure, friend. Thank you so much for inviting me here. Thank you.